Friends, we are beginning with the abstract noun. In the previous video, we had completed concrete nouns and we had found that concrete nouns were of four types: common, proper, collective and material. So in this video, we are going to study about abstract nouns. An abstract noun is a quality, idea, state or something that we can only think but can't be experienced through our five senses. These senses are eyes, ear, nose, tongue and skin. For example, if we talk about an aeroplane, aeroplane is a concrete noun because it can be seen. So we are using one of our five senses. But happiness can only be felt. It cannot be experienced through these five senses. So this is a basic difference between concrete and abstract nouns. Here are the examples of abstract nouns: anger, love, beauty, fear, freedom, kindness, sacrifice, determination, strength, success, trust, liberty, energy, hope, honesty, friendship, faith, anxiety, etc. These are the sentence examples of abstract nouns. We have used abstract nouns in the sentences, and out of any of these abstract nouns, you can see that none of these can be experienced through our five senses. So these words state the quality or feeling. Let's see how to form abstract nouns. Abstract nouns can be formed by adding some suffixes with adjectives, verb and common nouns. Suffixes are the words which are added with the word in the last. For example, these words are adjectives, and out of adjectives, abstract nouns are formed. Like honest is a quality, honest is an adjective, and we can make abstract noun out of honest, that is honesty. So we have added some letters with the honest and it has become honesty. In the same way, sweet is a quality. Sweetness is an abstract noun which is made by adding an es. Long is length. Kind is kindness. Brave is bravery. Loyal is loyalty. True is truth. The words given here are the qualities, but a question can arise that these words are also qualities. So how will we differentiate between the two? So I am mentioning one example here, like the king is very kind. Here kind is an adjective. How? Because adjectives are those words which modify noun. Kind is telling the quality of king, that king is very kind. So it is adjective. But when we write kind as an abstract noun like kindness, we write in this way: he is famous for his kindness. So this is also telling the quality, because in this sentence, he, who is a person, is in the state of being kind. We will see that how abstract nouns can be made through verbs. Verbs are the words which does action. Grow is a verb, and with little moderation, abstract noun can be formed, that is growth. Live, verb. Life is abstract noun, which is made out of it. Break, breakage. Waste, wastage. Know, knowledge. Speak, speech. Decide, decision. Like if I say, I know you very well, I am using it as a verb. But if I say, I have good knowledge about trees, so I am in the state or condition where I keep knowledge of trees. So knowledge will be abstract noun. Abstract nouns can be formed through common nouns too. Like friend is a common noun, but friendship will be abstract noun. Mother will become motherhood, child, childhood, slave, slavery, honor, ownership, like he is a honor, it's a common noun. The firm is running under his ownership. Leader, leadership, neighbor and neighborhood. So in this way, we can form abstract nouns out of adjectives, verbs and nouns. Exercise 1. To help you all, the rules of nouns are summed up here. The king did not show any sympathy. King is a person who is commonly found, so it is common noun. The sympathy is a state in which someone is sympathetic. So this state of condition is a feeling, so it will be an abstract noun. The rabbit ran across the street. Rabbits are many in number, so it's common noun. And streets are also multiple in number, So, common noun. Ajay works in a studio. Now, Ajay is the name of one person, and the names which are specific or particular are proper nouns. A question may arise here that we can find more than one Ajay around. So, why is it not common noun? The answer is that there can be many boys whose name are Ajay, but it is not that Ajay who works in a studio, and he cannot be found the same. So, it will be a proper noun. But studio can be multiple in numbers, so studio will be common noun. Mona ate a bunch of grapes. Mona is a person. The one more qualities of proper noun is that proper noun always begin with capital letter, so it will be proper noun. Bunch is called a group of grapes. It's a collective noun. But the word grapes will be common noun. The warm water melted the snow. The word water is common noun. It is found everywhere. Water can be of many types. And snow, in the same way, it's a common noun. Ravi is a man of great wisdom. Ravi is a one person. And he is a particular person. It's a name too. So, proper noun. And the word man, as per the definition, is common because they can be found many. Wisdom is a state in which someone is wise. So, it's a state of mind of being wise. So, it will be abstract noun. A team of doctors saved his life. Team is a group of doctors. So, it will be collective noun. While doctors are common people. So, it will be common noun. Life is a state in which we live. So, it will be abstract noun. The difference between abstract to other noun is that it cannot be experienced through our five senses. Calcium is good for health. Calcium is a substance or material. So, it will be material noun. And health is a state in which someone is healthy. So, it will be abstract noun. Bhim rides his cycle in the park. We can find a person Bhim who is one itself. So, it will be proper noun. It's beginning with capital letter also. Cycles can be found many, common noun. And parks also, you can see many around you. So, again, it's a common noun. A blackboard is made of wood. So, blackboards can be many. It's a common noun. But wood is a substance that is used to make blackboard. So, here wood will be material noun. My family will go on a picnic. So, family is a group of members. It's a collective noun. And picnic is a common noun. Picnic is a place. There is no freedom to speak in this city. Freedom is a state of being free. It's an abstract noun. And city are many. It's a common noun. This building is made of marbles. Building, a common noun. Marbles, a substance or material. So, material noun. Childhood is the time of joy and freedom. It's a unique sentence in which the four words that are childhood, time, joy and freedom all are abstract nouns. Because childhood is a state of being child. Time is a state which cannot be experienced through five senses. We can measure time with watch or clock, but time cannot be experienced. Joy is a state and freedom is also a state when someone is free. So, all these four words are abstract nouns. Piyush gifted me a clock. Piyush is one person. It's a name. So, it will be proper noun. And clocks will be many. So, here it is common noun. Before that, we had talked about time. That time can be measured through clock. So, clock can be a common noun. But time will be abstract noun. The evening brought darkness and peace. Evening is a common noun. Darkness and peace are the state of being dark and calm. So, these both will be abstract noun. Disease killed the knot of frogs. Disease means illness. It's a common noun. There can be many diseases. Knot is a group of frogs. So, groups are called collective nouns. And frogs can be many. So, it will be a common noun. The class is studying grammar. Class is a group of students. It will be collective noun. But grammar is a common noun. because grammar can be of any language. The teacher gave punishment to all. Teacher, a common noun. Punishment is a state of being punished. So it's an abstract noun. A herd of bison ran across the river. Herd is a group, so it will be collective noun. Bison, a common noun, and river again a common noun. Thanks for watching.